Hello. Okay, so I'm back. And I'm in the vehicle because it's quiet in here. And we just got home from church. And, oh, kids were loud. And they all have homework. And, yeah. Now my dog's going to go chasing something. Okay, so I've had a wild couple of weeks. I had COVID first. And then finally got over COVID. And then about, well, the very next day after I tested negative, I came down with a really bad stomach virus. And I mean, it was awful. I was in so much pain. I got over that. And then, let's see, that was Wednesday of last week. Friday, I was okay. Good. We had some time with my in-laws, had a nice time. And then, let's see, that was Friday. Saturday, I spent the whole day resting. That is what I'm doing now, is every Saturday I just rest and let my body recuperate because I need it. And I was fine all day Saturday. I felt tired, more tired than normal. Like I didn't just sleep, but I just felt fatigued. So therefore resting. Sunday morning, Easter Sunday, I thought, I'm good to go. I got up, started getting ready. I just had this feeling in the pit of my stomach, and I thought, what is wrong with me? So I decided I'd go ahead and get ready. Just push. So I did. Got myself completely ready. I was dressed. I had a little bit of makeup on. My hair was fixed. I felt put together. And then I got sick. My husband pulled up, so I had to explain to him what I'm doing out here in the van. I'm not just talking to myself. He pulled up and I was like, hello. So yeah, Sunday morning I got really sick. I was really sick to my stomach. And so I was sick all day that day. Missed church, hated missing Easter services and everything, but I was sick. Monday morning, I felt kind of off. Tuesday, I felt better. And then today, I feel pretty good. So, yeah. Anyway, today, I cleaned out my refrigerator, deep cleaned it, got a lot of condiments out. I don't know if any of you are like this, but we like a lot of condiments. We like chow chow relish, and we like mayonnaise. That's a big thing we use a lot of. We use a lot of Chick-fil-A sauce. That's a favorite. There's just a lot of sauces that we like. Well, we have a thing in our family with not just sauces, but pickles. There's lots of pickles in the fridge. So I went through today, and anything I could mix together, I did. Anything I could put in a smaller container, I did. And I threw out stuff that's been in there more than 6 months. Like, I know some of those pickled things. In fact, I have a jar of pickled okra that I'm not sure how long it's been open. And I'm going to tell my kids, if it's not finished this week, I'm throwing it out. Because it's been in the refrigerator, and nobody's touching it. It's not worth keeping the space, because I have limited space in my refrigerator. I do have a French door refrigerator that I dreamed of. It was my dream refrigerator, and we went to a place in Louisiana that does scratched or dented furniture at a discount. So for the same price as the exact same refrigerator that I had before, that we'd bought when my 15-year-old was little, it had gone out, and they had the exact same model, basically, you know, the newer version of it, but same type. It was the same exact cost as I paid for this one, and this was my dream refrigerator. So, I got it, love it, but it has limited tall space. Well, when you have a family as big as mine, you need milk. Milk is tall. It takes space. And not only do I have milk, I have my milk, or a regular whole milk. Then we have lactose-free milk, and then we have almond milk because we have different people that have different needs. Then we have my creamer, half and half. Then we have my daughter who is dairy free. We have her creamer. It adds up, especially if you buy two of each at a time or whatever. So I was realizing that I needed more tall space. So today when I pulled everything out, I was able to pull a shelf down and give myself an extra tall space. So I was like, yay. So I got all that done and then made space, which I'm actually going in a few minutes to pick up a pickup order at Walmart because we were out of a few things. But as far as budgeting goes, I have been on a, I'm on a stricter budget grocery wise now than I used to be. I have $150 a week for a family of seven. First week I did wonderful. Second week, this is the second week and I'm already blown past it, but cleaning out the refrigerator helped me make a plan of what to use that we already have. I have meat in the freezer and I have other things and I have WIC. I already got most of my WIC. So I made a meal plan and I wanted to share it with y'all, so that I can let y'all know. And then I'm hoping to do some videoing of the meal plan. It's, I've been so sick. There was no way I could. So no. So, all right. Tomorrow for lunch will be sandwiches. We have, deli meat in the refrigerator that had been frozen that needed to be, needs to be used. I thawed it out and, we'll do sandwiches for them to take to school and then we'll have sandwiches for lunch. My husband and I will. Another option would be meatloaf sandwiches because I made meatloaf a few days ago. Only a few people in my family actually eat meatloaf and I made a huge meatloaf because I'd forgotten that several of my kids hate meatloaf. We don't, like I said, I don't make it often and after I made it, they were like, no, we're not eating that. So it's really good meatloaf. I made it with stuffing mix. So I might have a meatloaf sandwich tomorrow. Sorry, I don't know if I got a bite on my cheek or what. It's itching. Tomorrow night, I don't have to cook supper. We actually have a couple of different things going on. I pick up my kids from school at 3:30. At 4:30, our town has a butterfly release on the square because it's for the CASA and foster care agencies. And so, CASA of East Texas. And we're going to go to that. We've gone the last several years. The kids love it because they give all the kids a little paper with a butterfly in it. And they all, everybody opens it at the same time and the butterflies just flutter out. It's beautiful. It's become a family tradition. And as soon as the kids saw the signs in town, they were like, Mom, are we going to go? I said, of course. So we have that tomorrow at 4:30. At 5 o'clock at the park, which is just up the road, my husband's work is having their 50th anniversary this year, and they are having a company picnic with hot dogs and all that stuff and games and prizes and stuff. So we'll be going straight from the square to the park. The park's right around the corner from our house, and my kids have already asked if they can ride their bikes up there. I explained to them, I'm like, the whole staff of Daddy's work, which is a big plant, it's going to be at the park. I don't think y'all need to bring bikes or skates or any of that stuff. I said, let's just take the van and go up there and be there for it and not do all that. They understood. Okay, so that's tomorrow. Friday, I'm going to go through the rest of this a little bit quicker. Friday, we're going to do pizza egg rolls, which Southern Frugal Mama, which I'm going to tag her, is one of my new favorite channels on YouTube. And so I'm gonna give her a shout out. She did these pizza egg rolls in one of her challenge videos and they looked so good. And so I went ahead and bought the only thing I had to buy for it was the pepperoni and the egg roll wraps. I already had the cheese, I already have I actually have leftover marinara sauce. So we're gonna have that for lunch on Friday. And then supper on Friday is gonna be chicken and cheese quesadillas. No, it's not. I gotta get more egg roll wrappers. we may switch this around. Okay, I'm gonna have to switch this. I promised my mother-in-law I would make her samosas, which, if you don't know what samosas are, it's an Indian, basically like an egg roll, but it's got meat and potatoes and curry. It's really good. I really got a bite on my face. It's itching. So I promised her I would do that Friday night, and I just thought of that. So the pizza egg rolls, we'll skip on that this week. I did buy pepperoni, but I can stick it in the freezer, or at least for that day. I might do it another day. And I'll make samosas, and we'll just do leftovers or something, or we might do the quesadillas for lunch and do the samosas for supper. So I don't have a pen with me, or I'd switch that on here. Okay, so that's that. The chicken and cheese quesadillas, which is, I'll do that for lunch that day. I have a rotisserie chicken already thawed that was in my freezer, so I'm gonna use that. And I'll do that for the quesadillas. And I have a big pot of beans cooked. So I'm gonna take that container of beans that's left over, divide it. Half of it I'm gonna use to mash and make refried beans to go with the quesadillas. The other half will go into the crock pot Saturday morning, along with ground beef, which I'm gonna cook Friday, and all the other stuff to make chili. And I'm gonna make a pot of chili in the Instant Pot Saturday morning to have for lunch on Saturday. So we'll have it already ready. And then on Saturday evening will be sandwiches or just warm up leftovers, something simple and easy because I don't want to cook. Sunday, I have a lot of chicken in my freezer that I need to start using. We'd gotten leg quarters for 49 cents a pound several months ago, and we got several bags. So I divided them up. I cut them up, and I put the drumsticks in one, the thighs in another bag, and my freezer's full of those bags. So I'm going to pull out a bag of the thighs, probably tonight, and stick it in there to start thawing. And so Sunday lunch will be baked chicken thighs and roasted vegetables or a salad, depending on how much time I have, because I'll get the chicken ready and get it put in before we leave for church. I might do chicken gourmet, which is a chicken and rice dish. I hadn't thought of that till just now, but that's something it takes 2.5 hours to cook. So it would be something I could mix up and start in the oven as soon as I'm leaving for church for Sunday school, and that should give it just enough time to be done. So I'm gonna tweak this a little bit. So that'll be Sunday for lunch, and that would be with a salad if I do the chicken and rice. Supper that night is another one of Southern Frugal Mama's creations. It's basically a beef stew pot pie. She uses a can of beef stew and then adds cream of mushroom, which I would use cream of chicken because I've got picky kids that don't like mushrooms. And then mix the vegetables, mixes all that together, puts it in like a pot pie, and then uses biscuit dough to put on top. Now, I do have 2 cans of Pillsbury biscuits that I got on sale the other day in my refrigerator, but I probably will make biscuit dough from scratch because I got buttermilk on sale the other day and I have that in the fridge. I have that in the freezer. It was quart sized jars. I got them on, or bottles. I got them on sale half price. So I poured out the very top of them and then I froze them so that they're fine. I can just pull it out, thaw out a little thing, and have just enough buttermilk to add with other milk if I want to for biscuits or cornbread or whatever. But that way I have a supply of buttermilk, because buttermilk I don't use all that often, but I'm starting to use a little bit more. All right. Let's see, the Sunday. Monday. Oh, and then she bakes it like a chicken pot pie, but it's beef, and her family loved it. All right. Lunch, Monday. A ramen stir fry. I'll use some frozen mixed vegetables that I've got for that. And I need to use those up soon. So I'll boil them on Sunday and get the vegetables cooked and ready. And then I'll make the ramen stir fry and have it ready in containers that my kids can just take it to school. And I've got a variation of sauces. I've got little soy sauce packs they can take if they want to. I've got teriyaki sauce and orange sauce, and they could put whatever they want in it and make it their own. Supper that night is going to be pretzel crusted pork chops, which is a shake and bake box mix that I love. And we really like it on pork chops. We don't like it on chicken all that much. So I am going to buy pork chops specifically for this. But that's that and pepperoni are the only meat that I'm buying for the next 2 weeks. So not too bad. Thursday, for lunch, beans, sausage, and rice. I'll cook beans in the Instant Pot, which is another. It's soup beans is what Brooke from Southern Frugal Mama calls them. And our Southern Frugal Mom. And they are so good. I made them the other night. We ate them. My kids love beans. Her beans are really good, the way she does them. So they're done in the Instant Pot, which is super quick and easy. So we will have beans, sausage, and rice for lunch on Tuesday. I'll make it ahead and have it in containers. Supper that night is a taco bake. I have some corn tortillas that need to be used, so I'll create a taco bake with that. Look up recipes and find something. Wednesday. Lunch will be leftovers. Supper will be lasagna. I have a ton of lasagna noodles that need to be used. I have ground beef in the freezer. The only thing I might need to buy for that would be if I use ricotta cheese or cottage cheese, something like that. Thursday, lunch is leftovers. We do a lot of leftovers for lunches, so I'll plan for that. Supper that night will be chicken and sausage gumbo. I know I have 1 pound of sausage left in the freezer. I don't know if I have two. So that's something I'm going to have to dig and see if I can find. I might have to buy a pack of sausage. But I think I could do half the pack of sausage in with the beans and rice. And the other half of sausage in with the gumbo. So that might work. Because I'm not going to make a gigantic pot of gumbo like I have always done. I'm going to do a smaller, just enough for our family for one meal. Or one meal plus a little leftovers. Just so that I'm not so overwhelmed. And then Friday, lunch is leftovers, which will, like I said, the gumbo. And then supper will be pizza. So the pepperoni that I've got in this order that I'm going to pick up tonight, I'm going to put half of the pepperoni in the pizza egg rolls. And the other half are going to go on the pizzas here. And if I have any leftover chicken, we can use that on the pizzas. If I have any leftover ground beef, I might keep, you know, a half cup of ground beef out of whatever I'm doing for the chili or the taco bake or whatever. I might take some of those meats and set them aside just for pizza. And we can do a meat lover's pizza or something like that. And I'll do the crust from scratch and all that. So that gets me through the 20th of this month with very few things I have to buy, if I have to buy anything at all. For sure the pork chops, for sure the, what else was it I said? I said something else. Anyway, I'll go back through my list and ricotta cheese or cottage cheese for the lasagna. That's pretty much it. And I use a lot of pantry stuff for this, a lot of freezer stuff, and I think it's a pretty balanced out meal plan. So that's my plan. And I should be getting a message any minute now from Walmart letting me know my order's ready. I'm going to go get that, come back. And then another thing I've been dealing with is not sleeping. I've been having insomnia. Even taking melatonin, I wake up after a few hours and just 3 o'clock in the morning, wide awake, can't sleep. So tonight, as soon as I get done with my Walmart order, I am going to turn my phone completely off, come home, get everything done, nighttime routines, and go to bed with my phone in a drawer if I need to keep myself from looking at it. And that way it's not a distraction, and maybe it'll help me sleep better. Might not. I don't know. So that's my plan. If I wake up at 3 a.m. and I cannot sleep, I might pull it back out again, but hopefully I can sleep tonight. So hope y'all have a great weekend. The next couple of days, whatever. Today's Wednesday. I will probably upload this tomorrow after I get it edited and everything, which I'll upload it on Thursday. And then on Thursday. I hope to video some when we do the butterfly release, and I might get a couple video clips at the park for the company thing, and I'll try to do a little video of our fun day, and then I'll try to get video of cooking. So I hope you all have a wonderful week and weekend, and I will be back later, and I'm glad to be back.